Well, football star, Rhodes Scholar, and now resident neurosurgeon. They're all under the belt of Bohemian Myron Roll, but now he's helping to tackle the novel coronavirus pandemic. Our Amajel Knowles spoke with him in this report.
He made global headlines when he decided to forego a promising NFL career in order to pursue his dream of becoming a neurosurgeon, something that is currently now a reality. Dr. Myron Roll, who is now in his third year as a neurosurgery resident at the Massachusetts General Hospital, is on the front lines in the fight against COVID-19. With his facility already experiencing over 4,000 COVID-19 cases, Dr. Roll spoke to the ZNS News team about his experience.
Right now at our hospital, Mass General, Harvard, in Boston, it's a hotbed for COVID-19. We expect to see a surge in a week or two of infected patients. And so our hospital has really transformed the whole look of it, basically. I mean, you walk in and it's like airport security. You have to go and get a mask, you get hand sanitizer. There's no more visitors that are allowed to be here. Our operating rooms have been turned into ICUs and our elective surgeries have been canceled. And our neurosurgical floor has been transformed into a COVID-19 patient only floor. And they've recruited other physicians like a neurosurgeon like myself to take part in managing some of these patients. So it's sort of an all hands on deck and repurposing some of the personnel at our hospital, because we're having a lot of doctors and nurses get sick as well and not be able to be a part of the fight. So we're just trying to conserve and preserve as many people as we can, and also the protective equipment that we can. So that's troubling. And, you know, right now, there's just so many dynamic features to this disease.
And with the numbers starting to rise here on home soil, Roll lamenting to Bahamians to heed the words of health officials, as a life they save may very well be their own.
It's infectious. We know that. It hits a certain subset of the population very hard, the older folks with comorbidities. But it can hit anyone, and it can hit athletes. It can hit young people. You can be asymptomatic carriers. So that's why it's so important that every member of our community, every member of our Bahamian community especially, takes this seriously and adheres to the policies of staying home, social distancing, physical distancing, proper lifestyle behavior modifications, good hygiene, being aware and alert of any symptoms that may happen, being aware and alert of any exposure that you may have had. It's better to get out front of the disease if you suspect that you have it, rather than allow it to take over your body and then it might be too late. So my advice to my home in the Bahamas is basically just to everyone play an active role. Everyone understand that this is something that we're going to get through. We'll get over it, but we need time for the nurses, the doctors, the epidemiologists, the scientists, the PhDs, the pharmacists, all the brilliant minds, the intellectual giants that are really working expeditiously to not only find vaccines and cures, but also management and preventative measures to stop it from happening again in the future.
Roll also preaching the importance of patience.
Just about being patient and getting comfortable being a little bit uncomfortable in a very trying time like this. This is something new. We all weren't ready for it. As medical professionals, we weren't ready. And obviously the population in the demos, whether it be in America or the Bahamas or other parts of the world, certainly not ready for it either. But the healthcare system cannot be stressed. The local government can't be stressed. You know, our pride and our civility and our dignity as a people in the Bahamas can't be stressed, because it won't stand for a long time if that's the case. And so in order for us to sort of thwart that and go the opposite direction, we all need to play our part.
Roll has also used his platform recently as a neurosurgery resident and appeared on ESPN, Fox, and The Athletic to bring further awareness of the COVID-19 pandemic and bridge the gap between the worlds of sports and medicine during this time. For ZNS News, I'm Amajal Knowles.